Hi guys! We are coming up on the holidays. It's actually holiday season now. Of course, you're seeing Christmas commercials and Thanksgiving commercials, and the Christmas trees are coming out, and it is spectacular. It's my favorite time of the year, but we all know what this means. I don't even think I have to tell you. This is a time of the year that people indulge in a lot of food, a lot of shopping, and a lot of family time. And unfortunately, that often means a lot of weight gain. So today, I decided that I would share with you a few simple steps to stay fit and healthy during the holidays. Let's jump right into it. So I think this is the most obvious tip, but guys, we live in the age of the internet. There are a ton of resources for healthy meals. If you can think it and if you can use your mind and use the internet, you can find healthier options. Go to Pinterest and look up healthy casseroles, healthy stuffings, healthy turkey recipes. It is there, you just have to dive into it and look for it. So it's the holiday season, you're gonna be spending time with family anyways. Why not take the time to be active with them? How about you say, hey guys, how about we go for a walk and we talk while we're walking? Because it's fun, it gets you moving, it gets everybody active, and you're still remaining active while spending time with your family. On a day when you know that you're gonna be eating a super large meal, whether this be Christmas or Thanksgiving or whatever you celebrate, do a leg workout that morning. Why? Let's think about it. Your legs contain the largest muscle group in the body. What happens when you have leg day? When you have leg day, your body needs more nutrition. It needs more calories because all of that is gonna go towards that muscle group to energize it, to replenish it, to repair it. So if you know that you're gonna be indulging later and you don't want it portion control or you don't wanna take it easy, hit it really hard in the morning for leg day. Get those muscles working and get it to where they need that nourishment from the food. Dance! We all love to dance. You don't have to be like a salsa queen or, I don't know, a YMCA expert professional. You just need to get up and get moving. You know, in my house, this means when we're cooking, when we're preparing, when we're doing Christmas gifts, the music is on. And that just means, you know, making a little bit of movement. Keep yourself moving. Have fun. Get your children. Grab their hands. Spin them around. Just keep moving and having a good time and not focusing on working out and getting exercise, but getting moving while you're having a good time. We all love holiday shopping, I know I do. So when you go to the mall to go shopping, instead of driving around for 30 minutes looking for a parking spot up close while people are trying to get out, park all the way at the end of the parking lot. Park as far as you can and walk. Now of course I encourage you to stay safe. I don't necessarily recommend this, women, if you are alone, but if you're with your family, if you're with your husband, if you're with a friend, park as far as you can and get that little bit of exercise from your car to your mall. Always, always, always choose stairs over the elevator. There's no reason you should be sitting, waiting for an elevator to come down and getting on the elevator and riding it up and waiting for the doors to open. Just take the stairs. It's quicker and you're staying active while getting where you need to go. Encourage fitness, but get stuff for your family that you can do together. I haven't really pre-thought out what that could be before this video, but I don't know. I mean, me and my husband, we like to be active together. We like to keep our family active. So we do things like buying tennis rackets. So maybe you can buy tennis rackets for your whole family so you guys can pick up tennis. Or maybe you can take a family member to, you know, Fitnich and get them customized running shoes if they had, you know, showed interest in running. Or getting the person who is trying to just burn a little more calories, get them a little monitor that tells them how many steps they've taken. There's just things that you can do to encourage fitness in your family without shoving it down people's throats. So I highly encourage you to kind of listen to what people are telling you, and maybe they're not being direct with it, but maybe they're telling you, man, I really feel like I'm gaining weight and I don't know what to do about it and I just feel so discouraged. Buy them a fun program. Buy them a program that you intend to do with them. Maybe that's hip hop abs where it's dancing, or Brazil butt lift that's really fun but you're exercising at the same time. Just do something that you intend to do with them that you can have fun and that it doesn't look like a chore to them. It looks like spending time with them, getting active, getting fit at the same time. There are people who will say, I'm not gonna eat all day long so that I can stuff my face at Thanksgiving dinner.
No, 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 no.
You should be eating as usual, making sure that at least your foods through the day are super nutritionally dense. Maybe drink a Shakeology, maybe drink a shake. Making sure that you're choosing really healthy options before the meal so that you're not going into the meal just wanting to completely shove your face. Use small plates, okay? So rather than use a big plate and stuff that, if you use a small plate and you kind of fill that up, it tricks your mind into thinking, hey, I have a lot of food, this is great, but in all actuality, you are sticking to your portion sizes. So I don't want you to give up on any food during the holidays. If there are stuffings, if there are, you know, turkey, if there are desserts, have it, but have it in moderation. Just choose things that are a little more mindful of what you're eating and how much you're eating without completely depriving yourself of the food, because otherwise you're gonna go back later and just stuff your face and completely binge eat. And the final tip, as you can see, water. Water is a no-brainer all day, every day, holiday or not. Drink the water so that you're satisfied and so that you're not starving and your stomach isn't completely empty. Also, if you are having a, you know, Christmas party at work or a Thanksgiving party at work, don't give in to the alcohol. Have maybe one drink, one glass of wine, one glass of champagne, and then stick with water the rest of the night. And that also opens it up for conversation. You know, if people are saying, why are you not drinking? You can tell them, like, hey, you know, I'm trying to be mindful of what I'm eating and what I'm drinking. I'm trying to be healthy throughout the holiday season so that when January comes around, I don't feel, you know, like a slob. I don't feel bad about myself. And you never know, right then and there, you might have found yourself a new workout party. A new workout person, friend, partner is what I was trying to say. So those are my 10 tips for staying healthy and fit during the holiday. Of course, I could give you a million more, but we don't want to keep this video like too long. So I would love to hear from you. Leave in the comment section down below what your tips are for staying fit and healthy during the holiday. And I will see you guys later. Bye.